Tom Suozzi. I'm a congressman from Long Island and Queens and governor of the state as a common sense Democrat. We've got a crime crisis in New York State.
Thank you, sir. About that. Okay.
Could you start all over again, sir?
I'm Tom Suozzi. I am a congressman from Queens and Long Island. I'm running for governor of New York State as a common sense Democrat. I'm here today about the crime crisis we're facing here in New York State. We've got a real crime crisis in our state, and there's no place that's more evident than right here in New York City. We've had 5 police officers shot during the course of this month. Last week, 4 new NYPD officers were victims of gun violence. One, as we know, died in the line of duty. Another one's hanging on for his life. I just was inside looking at the board of the Wall of Honor. This is the first police officer that's been killed from this precinct since the 1970s. There were 5 officers killed in the 1970s. No deaths since the 70s. This is the first police officer that's been killed. And we're mourning with this entire precinct and the entire city, and with everybody who supports law enforcement. And we're praying for the officer that's fighting for his life right now. We had an 11-month-old baby girl. 11-month-old baby girl, right before her birthday, 1-year birthday, got caught in the crosshairs of a gunfight. We had earlier this month a 19-year-old woman who was saving money for nursing school, who was shot and killed in a botched robbery while working at a Burger King. So we all know about the statistics. The number of homicides went up by 50% from 2019 to 2021. The number of shootings went up by 100% from 2019 to 2021. And it's totally unacceptable. And New York State needs leadership to address these problems. The mayor has called upon leaders at all levels to support him in his effort to address crime here in New York City. I was an early endorser of Eric Adams. He asked me to serve as his deputy mayor. I support his agenda to address crime here in New York City 100%. Now I want to talk about Governor Hochul. He's really done nothing about the crime crisis that we're facing here in the city and here in the state of New York. She talks about how gun violence is such a problem, she needs help from Washington, D.C. Well, I want you to know that I'm on every single piece of gun violence prevention legislation there is in New York, in Washington, D.C. I'm on every single piece of legislation. And there are some people in Washington, D.C. that are beholden to the NRA that refuse to support common sense gun legislation. Kathy Hochul served in Congress for 2 years. She got an A rating from the NRA. She was supported by the NRA. She didn't support common sense gun legislation at the time. She boasted about the fact when she served as the Erie County Clerk that she made it easier to purchase a firearm under her watch. So now she wants Washington to fix the problem, but when she was in Washington, she sided with the NRA against Common Sense Gun Violence Prevention Act advocates. So I'm here today to say that we can't have people that pander, whether they pander in the old days or they're pandering today. We need people to stand up and be leaders to support law enforcement and to support efforts to address this crime problem. I believe in all the ideas that people talk about prevention. 75% of the people in jail have drug, alcohol, or mental health issues. There's no question about that. 50% of the people at Rikers Island have a learning disability. We need to do whatever we can to prevent crime from happening. For prevention, and I've got specific agenda items that I'll lay out here today, takes a long period of time to address. And right now we need intervention, not just prevention, but intervention to address the crime that's happening on our city streets as we speak. So we heard last week, Mayor Adams said we need Albany and the DAs to act. When it came to the district attorneys, Governor Hochul has been silent. The district attorney here in Manhattan says he won't prosecute resisting arrest. He wants to reduce armed robbery down to a misdemeanor. The governor's been absolutely silent on this issue. The mayor's come out and said, we have to do something about bail reform. We need to give judges the authority to look at people's previous records and to take into account dangerousness and public safety for remanding people. The governor says, I'm going to wait and see what the legislature says about it. She's not taking a position on the issue. So we need people to take leadership. Mayor Adams tweeted the other day, leaders at every level have abandoned our city streets. So I want to make it very clear that I will take action to address the crime problem that we face here in New York City. So I've got a 15-point plan. And I'll talk about the 15 different points here today. And my staff says people aren't going to want to listen to my whole 15 points. But I'm going to go through the 15 points. Number one, we need to fix the bail reform law to give judges the authority to take into account dangerousness and to remand people. Number two, if a district attorney refuses to enforce the law, they should be removed. The governor has the power to do that, to either remove the district attorney or to have the attorney general prosecute the law. It can't be that you can resist arrest in Manhattan, but you can't resist arrest in Queens. You can commit an armed robbery and not be prosecuted for a felony in Manhattan, but if you do an armed robbery in Brooklyn, you'll get prosecuted. It can't be. If you want to change the law, run to the state legislature and change the law. It can't be that you pick and choose which laws as the district attorney you're going to enforce. Number three, we need to reinstitute a targeted stop, question, and frisk program where we have trained officers, certified, who can go out into targeted areas and try and identify who we know are the people that are users of guns, that have guns, and use stop, question, and frisk in a responsible manner. And then track the behavior of police officers to look at use of force and to look at issues of people of color and whether people's civil liberties are being violated. But you can't say you can't give the police the power to go out and try and prevent this crime from happening. We need to improve the juvenile justice system. We need to fund the DAs so that they can take into account this new discovery law and they can actually implement this law. Second, we need to get the guns off the street. We need a multi-state commission. Everybody working to stop the guns from coming in. We need to use ShotSpotter, which I started when I was Nassau County Executive. I served as Nassau County Executive from 2002 to 2009. I ran the 12th largest police department in the United States of America, bigger than Boston, bigger than Detroit. We have the safest community, over 500,000 people anywhere in the United States of America. We had a gun violence issue. We implemented ShotSpotter. We need to use ShotSpotter as effectively as we have in the city currently. We need to use more of it. We need to take the shell casings that we find in sites so we don't apprehend somebody and put them into the National Integrated Ballistic Information Network. We need to expand gun buybacks to clergy and not-for-profits to bring guns off the street, buy them, so families can get them off the street. We need to fully implement New York's red flag law. We have a law in place that nobody's talking about. We just passed a law a couple years ago here in New York State that if a family member or a social worker or a police officer knows somebody owns a gun, even if it's a legally owned gun, but that person demonstrates that they have a mental illness or a drug alcohol problem, that gun, you can take that gun away from the person by going through a due process in the courts. In the old days, you couldn't do that. Now you can do it. We need to give people the resources to implement the red flag law. We need to unite behind some common sense federal legislation, but I wouldn't count on it based upon some of the folks beholden to the NRA in Washington, D.C. And finally, we need to do prevention to prevent future crimes. We need to bring every social service that we have, every federal, state, local, not-for-profit, every social service we have, bring it into our schools to implement community schools, implement something like the Harlem Children's Zone in every single troubled school in New York State so we can identify kids that are having problems at young ages so the problems in their lives can be addressed before they turn into big problems later on, because drugs, alcohol, and mental health are issues that lead to not only crime, but to poverty, to homelessness, to domestic violence. Let's address those issues at young ages. And let's bring in my No Rule War program that I did out in Nassau County. Let's expand the use of programs like SNUG and other community engagement to help the high-risk people. And we need to expand Kendra's law. We need to give the cops the power to say, listen, here's a homeless guy on the streets. There's a big gaping sore on his leg. He's muttering. He's obviously, he's out in 10-degree weather and is sleeping on the street. That person is obviously a danger to themselves and to others. We need to give cops the power to take mentally ill people out of the subways, off the streets, and get them into facilities. And there needs to be a coordinated effort to do so. Right now, it's just piecemeal patchwork. Why is it that we were able to get mentally ill people into facilities and off the streets under previous administrations? It can't just be that everybody goes into jail. They need to go to mental health facilities. They need to go to shelters. They need to go to medical facilities. So we need to get mentally ill people off the streets. We need to expand Kendra's law to give more power to police officers to take mentally ill people off the streets. Okay.
Congressman, on bail reform, is there any daylight between you and the mayor on that issue?
No.
Same question on his modified version of the anti-crime street.
No, I agree with him. 100%. Yeah. I think that, listen, bottom line is, stop, question, and frisk was abused in the old days. Okay? It was used much too broadly. You need officers that are properly trained, that have proper certifications, that can go out, and there are known gang members. There are known people that have guns that we should be able to go stop, question, that's a very important part of question, through the proper process and frisk to find out if they can remove guns from people, get them off the streets. Then we should monitor the activities of the police officers using statistics. We use statistics for CompStat. We should use statistics to monitor the activity of the police officers to make sure they're properly using force, that they're properly not targeting people just based on their color, but based upon real information. That requires training and certification.
How much daylight is there between that and that issue?
We really don't know, because the governor has been completely silent on the issue of bail reform. She's been completely silent on the Manhattan DA's decision to not prosecute certain crimes. She hasn't taken any leadership position whatsoever on those issues. And you missed earlier when she was in Congress, so she's talking now about we need the federal government to do a better job on anti-gun violence prevention laws. I'm on every single piece of legislation there is for gun violence prevention. Kathy Hochul, when she was in Congress, was endorsed by the NRA, and she was funded by the NRA in her campaign. She boasted when she was the Erie County Clerk that she made it easier for people to purchase guns.
Right. So explain to me why it's politically difficult.
Rochester, New York, where they have a record number of homicides since 2006. We've got a problem in Buffalo. We've got a problem in other places throughout the state as well. Crime is a major issue, and Democrats like myself need to be talking about this issue and addressing this issue in a real way.
Can I ask you a question about the mask mandate? Do you agree with the mask?
Democrat, I'm going to fight fight crime and lower taxes, protect the environment, and help our troubled schools. Okay. Who are you with, by the way?
Beyond expanding Pender's law, can you talk a little bit about whether you think the state law needs to be tightened to lower the bar for people who are unwell to be forced to into involuntary? Because right now, even if you expand Pender's law, then it applies to some, it involves the courts. And we have outreach teams when it comes to people in who are very unwell. Very often, expanding is not enable hospitals to keep them inside.
This has to be an all-hands-on-deck approach, okay? When I talk to police officers, the biggest problem they face is that they know that somebody is clearly mentally ill, is clearly a danger to themselves, and they can't get them into an ambulance, over to a hospital, over to a mental health facility. We need to make sure that we have the services available, and this needs to be a coordinated effort. Again, you know, we have this big, giant state government. We have this big city government. We have all these different federal dollars. We need a coordinated plan to get homeless people up the street. I will never get the image out of my mind of seeing a homeless man who had a big sore on his leg. He was quite right about that thing. It was pink, it was raw, it was oozing. He was muttering to himself. He clearly could not take care of himself. And there was nothing I could do. I gave him a few dollars, is all I could do. We have to utilize the resources that we have, our police. Utilize the resources we have, our social workers at not-for-profits. Utilize the resources we have with hospitals and mental health facilities. Utilize the resources that we have with judges and jails when necessary. And we have to get mentally ill people off the streets when they're a danger to themselves or to the public, and we need to make it easier to do so. It's common sense.
Do you have an idea how
we have to expand the authority under Kendall's law to do so. And I'll take any ideas I can from my friends in law enforcement, in mental health areas to do this. Just do this in the beginning, okay? I know that 75% of people in jail are not having a mental health. I know that 50% of people in Rikers Island have a learning disability. There are so many things we can do to prevent crime and homelessness and poverty for the long term. And we should do those things. And I have plans to do those things. But that's prevention. We also need to do intervention. We need to stop crime from happening. And that's really some of the things that we're lacking right now that we need to get back to doing. Anything else?
Thank you.
I'm gonna baby stay until I'm gonna get knocked out.